Hello students, in this part of the video we will discuss all the phases of meiosis cell division. But let us first know the aim of the experiment. So the aim of the experiment is to study meiosis in onion bud cells through permanent slides. Now the materials required are permanent slide of different stages of meiosis in onion bud cells, and then we need a microscope. After that we will write the procedure. For procedure, we fix the permanent slide under the microscope. Then first we observe the slide under the low power microscope, low power lens, and then under high power lens to observe all the phases of the meiosis cell division. Then we will start observing all the phases. So the first phase is the meiosis first, and meiosis first the longest phase is prophase first. The prophase first, it has 5 sub stages. That is, the first phase is leptotene. Here you can see the structure of leptotene. In leptotene, the chromatin fibers condense and form thick thread like structure called chromosomes. Here you can see the chromosomes, nuclear envelope and nucleolus are distinct. You can see the nucleus here. Then in second slide, the homologous chromosomes, they used to form pairs whom we call the bivalent. This pairing is called synapses. The individual of a pair are similar in length and in position of their centromere. Now the third phase, subphase is pachytene. In pachytene you can see that two chromatids of each chromosomes become visible, so that a bivalent become a tetrad. And crossing over takes place between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. The next phase is the diplotene. In this phase, you can see two chromosomes of each bivalent move away and homologous are left together at one or more point, and that point we call chiasma. It is written, you can see the last subphase is, that is, diakinesis. In diakinesis you can see the homologous chromosomes, they appear thick and ring shaped. Nucleus and nuclear envelope, it disappears and spindle begins to form. You can see the spindle it begins to form. Here the prophase first finished. After that comes metaphase first. In metaphase first, the homologous chromosomes arrange themselves at the equator of the spindle. Here you can see that the chromosomes, they have arranged themselves at the equator. The spindle gets attached to the centromere of the chromosomes. The centromere, it is attached with the spindle. Now in the anaphase first, you can see the anaphase first. In anaphase first, the two chromosomes of each bivalent move to the opposite poles, and each pole has half the number. Each pole has half the number of chromosomes with two chromatids each. After that, the next phase is telophase first. In telophase first, you can see the chromosomes at each pole, they starts uncoiling, and nucleolus and nuclear envelope, it reappears. Cytokinesis occurs to form two haploid daughter cells. After this interkinesis takes place. Students, meiosis second includes four stages, that is prophase second, metaphase second, anaphase second, and telophase second. Here you can see prophase second, metaphase second, anaphase second, and after that telophase second. So we will discuss one by one. In prophase second, the chromosomes of daughter cells begin to condense and become thick. Here again, the chromosomes, they again start condensing and becoming thick. Nuclear envelopes and nucleolus, it begins to disappear. You can see here the nuclear and nuclear membrane, it starts disappearing. Now in metaphase second, the chromosomes are arranged on the equator of the spindle. Here you can see the chromosomes, they are arranged at the equator of the spindle. Now each chromosome is held by the spindle at the centromere in the both poles. So they have, chromosomes have arranged themselves on the equator and attached with the spindle at the centromere. Now after that comes the anaphase. In anaphase second, the sister chromatids, that we call the daughter chromosomes of each chromosomes, separate and migrate towards opposite poles. Each pole thus receive haploid number of chromosomes. And at last, telophase second takes place. In telophase second, as you can see, the chromosomes begin to uncoil and become thin. The nuclear envelope and nucleolus, it starts reappearing. After this, the cytokinesis occurs and we get four daughter cells, each with haploid number of chromosomes. So in this way, you have got four daughter cells with haploid number of chromosomes. Students, some precautions you will take while this experiment, that the first one, that floral buds should be fixed between 8 to 10 a.m. and slides should be warmed gently to avoid overheating. So this is all about this experiment.